date per se. Once I have a new girlfriend, we'll have to have a discussion as to how she was acquired, Dan.
What's a girlfriend? We will need to have a discussion. What does that even mean? All right, guys, we've got some Counter-Strike here. Follow Esports. Team, Peter's team, which finally have a name, which is great. I actually wanted to call them the Back Alley Doctors. That's what I was. What there was a working title for a while, but
that's horrific.
It's good, man.
Because, well, just calls Counter-Strike down.
Oh, we do have the push on short coming in from Liquid straight away, and that's going to be two frags for a kiss, and Adrenaline Maker the piece. He can actually create a redeeming moment here for his team, but he's going to get caught out, and there's no frag back for Liquid. They're having quite a hard time here. Just one player left now, and he is gone as well. So, pretty unfortunate round for Liquid. They had a nice idea with the catwalk push. It's pretty high risk, and obviously they ran into a lot of players and just couldn't win the battle. So it's the nature of the beast, and they're going to start off with a low economy. And Follow Esports can bully them. In fact, Follow Esports not going with any SMGs at all, like, in this round.
Can we look at my CT money quickly? Correctly. See, they haven't gone for the force buy, Dan. They have accepted their fate. They shall look to get an AWP, at least one, on the third round. I'm curious, actually, because it's so rare that you see a CT side just eco when they lose a pistol. I'm wondering if they're going to go for two warps. Maybe you have one short as well, for example.
But you say that's rare. There's not a single SMG. There's two AKs and three gills. That is incredible. That's almost more rare that you see that these days, that there is not even a single SMG.
Yeah, they're respecting their opponents, Dan. That's what it is. They're respecting their opponents. Respect it. But look at this read here from Liquid. They're rotating the entire team over towards the A bomb site. And Follow Esports are headed in that direction. They still have a minute on the clock here. But again, with this buy-up of the big guns, they've got basically no grenades to clear out any nook, any cranny of any kind.
And we've got the push from Studio 2K that could happen soon. Hopefully sooner rather than later for his team. They're actually already pushing in towards B, so they've I think worked out that there's nobody really present towards B and that the stack is in A. So good for Follow Esports, nicely done that they've avoided the stack. And you can see that they tried to play cognizant to the possibility of a potential stack as well, as they, you know, in the way that they were moving before up catwalk, it gives them a lot of options to trade and to back away towards A if it doesn't go so well there. And they also have Stewie who was spotting as well, so it's a nice little, a cute little kind of play. But poor Stewie, man, he's got four guys about to pinch him, and he's able to take down two of them, which is kind of nice. Good coordination from Liquid.
The discipline on Team Liquid is awesome to watch.
Yeah.
They're so unlike basically any other North American team at this point, which is good.
Yeah. I think right now CLG is much closer than Cloud9 in that sense. Because Cloud9 seemed a little bit all over the place. Less than usual. Because Cloud9
more than usual?
Less than in recent months. I mean, since
all over the place.
Yeah.
More
all over the place. Because initially when they started to do very well, it was one of the reasons was their team play was so tight and well coordinated. And the defaults were super strong and so on. But anyway, Cloud9 is another discussion. As we do have the play coming in from Liquid here, just able to, of course, have Galil to play with us on Hiko. And with this aggression, they're actually going to get some damage done here towards the apartments area. And that is just going to leave Fugly left alone. Unfortunately, they weren't able to pick up any more players. But it's also to the merit, it's also to the, we've got to credit Follow Esports and how they actually approach this round, because they were ready for that.
Credit to Liquid as well. Like, I like how late Nitro peaked from the underpass once his teammate went down, for example, which was a nice touch. Although, one thing I noticed on NIP, actually, when they played Mirage at the Major, normally you see people drop a pop flash, the T's, on an anti-eco or whatever, just regardless, they'll just drop a pop flash down there. But on the anti-eco, they'll drop a HE down there instead. So if anybody's playing close, and that's half their life gone already. So something I've definitely picked up and started to do. Although I haven't played CS for 2 weeks, right? So I've got no coordination. I dropped a HE down there, took half a guy's life, and peaked for AK, and got wrecked there.
You should have tried to bludgeon him, James.
Indeed.
The AK.
Got out of the old club. Right, so how many orbs will we see on the Liquid side? Actually, from the money they spent, might be a little bit awkward. They should be able to buy it still, but they'll be lacking helmets. Indeed, you can see Adrian. He will be the sole sniper. So Liquid just going for the disciplined conservative buy. That will allow them to get more nades than they otherwise would have. Goes for a fast push. Rue surely saw that there was one player there. Two-man spray down for him, and this buy from Liquid is...
gone?
Disappearing very gone quickly. They've been robbed at a petrol station there. Or the gas station. I'm sorry, we're in North America now.
That was rather interesting. That, again, that's just... that's kind of a if you blinked, you missed it sort of around there. Liquid just fought, like losing three players immediately, and that's basically round over in that way. So they're gonna be going down 5-0 most likely because they have to full eco in the following round. And so this is a pretty sick start for Follow Esports. And I think we took we didn't get to actually submit our team, but I think we were taking more players from Follow Esports than from Winterfox. So it worked out quite well for us, James. But either way, this is a nice opportunity for Follow Esports to show what they're really capable of. As you know, when you have this situation where you have all the money to play with and you have that advantage, when you're playing against a better team, you can of course, you know, because of those advantages, post a better result and also show you know, much more of your team. You know, whereas if you don't have many opportunities, of course, the opposite is true. So Deagle for Alish and a few PT-50s, but that's all that Follow Esports have to worry about.
Well, Liquid stacking the A site once more. Follow Esports playing the patient game. While we have a small lull, I actually forgot to mention earlier that we collected a few pins from Collusion of Poker, so we'll be giving one away to subscribers after this match. Make sure you stay tuned. So far, so good on this anti-eco here. Ake's going to be the point man. Oh dear, not working out now. Shadow has not been covered properly. And there's something to mention about it. Look at the damage done here. Only two people surviving and Stewie's down to 11 HP, so that could have been even worse. So Follow Esports with good intentions, but see, it was a bit lacking in places. There was a recent video that shows when you go towards Tetris, you can basically Molotov Shadow from there. Which, so it gives you another option. Because obviously most people will Molotov it from the Palace area. So yeah, something that was missing from the approach to Follow Esports here. Good to see though that they have four Molotovs in this round.
Yeah, double AWP comes in, Adren and Fugly. But Follow Esports are playing a pretty fast round actually, pushing three players up short already, very early into the round. And they're going straight for the B split. This is actually looking quite strong. Stewie's going to get the opening onto Hiko. Just Nitro left in the corner there. He'll be able to take down Stewie. What more damage can he do? Oh, not very much. Nice jump through the smoke from Akis there. He will eliminate Nitro. But still, disadvantage here for Follow Esports. All the CTs with their attention turned towards this B site, and there's not really much time to actually get the bomb planted and move to, and for them to move to safe post-plant positions. They're gonna have to make do with where they are right now. Is it gonna pan out here? With a kiss there, he's gonna take down Fugly. Now the last man standing. So three players dead for Liquid, but they'll win the round.
So Leisure's defusing. Which makes me wonder if he's going to look for the other ADO. Okay, it's right there. I was going to say, if it wasn't close, oh, they've got AWPs galore. If it wasn't close, it would have been wise to collect the AWP first, but it was in very close proximity, and Liquid will make it onto the scoreboard.
The money is outrageous for Follow Esports. Because they've lost two rounds in a row, James. And, okay, they did get the bomb down there. Sorry. They lost a lot of players in the previous round, sorry. And they still had so much money to play with. It's kind of nuts.
It is indeed. So, Follow Esports with two people top mid at the moment. Bomb looks headed towards A. So it looks like this is a fairly standard split from the players. They've got there's a T walking in underpass as well, just to keep the solid control of mid. Three people now over towards the B bomb site for Liquid. If they get smoked off on short, they're not going to yet. There's a play coming on Shadow, but Peter's going to be the one going down despite getting the angle first. Adrenaline with another frag there, interconnector. But they don't need that good rotation. Bomb's been spotted, bomb goes down in sandwich as well. This will give Liquid time to rotate. 5-2 now. And Follow Esports needs to concentrate on doing some damage at the very least.
Well, here we go, 3-2k on the site. Take an extra player down there, so that's going to be nice economic damage. But can he actually do more? Can he even possibly try to win the round here? There's three AWPs in the hands of the remaining Liquid players. That is definitely pretty savage to deal with when you just have a rifle yourself and you're the last man standing. See if he can get it done. Make his way off. Fake flash there. He's going to mess up the jump, though, unfortunately. Might have actually worked, but Adrenaline will take him out. And it was a really nice play from Catwalk. And one thing about that as well is that they noticed, I think, the very fast pace of Follow Esports. Because Follow Esports have been playing at fast pace of their rounds. for the last few buy rounds here, and Liquid finally figured that out. It was catching them off guard, of course, initially. Now they can try to play a little bit more passively against it. And what Follow Esports should probably think about is, well, it looks like they're going to go for the execute, but it would be interesting to see if they decide as a response to actually slow down their play, really slow the pace after having such a high tempo. That's something that some teams are very, very good at and can use to great effect. But we'll see the delayed A execute in this round. And Fuggly's able to look over the top of the smoke here. No smoke for Stairs. Great flash, though. A Kissable will take full advantage of Fuggly as the plant can go down within the smoke. And we've got a nice perimeter, which is now being set up by the T side of Follow Esports around the bomb site. And Alish will be able to circumvent this somewhat, just shooting straight through the smoke to take the first frag to try to build into this retake. But this setup here from Follow Esports is rather strong, to say the least. And Root, if he can get some good timing on the peak, he's going to do a lot of damage. This one frag and the second one as well. Just Hiko left alive now. He's going to tag on to Stewie, but one versus two, and there's no time left, and the bomb is ticking so fast, and the round will be successful for Follow Esports. Brilliant stuff, considering that Liquid just won a round. They've been reset now, and Follow Esports already had quite a bit of money in the bank still, so they're still looking really good. I mean, they will spend quite a bit here, but there's definitely a buffer after they crush this anti-eco.
This is a very strong start from the T side here, representing the new brand well so far. Still early days, however. Well, Fuggly didn't get a headshot, actually, somehow. But there we go. The kill's a kill. Good start from Follow Esports again. Another anti-eco playing it faster on this occasion. I see some Molotovs as well moving quickly into the site. So changing the approach will make it hard for Liquid to counter future ecos should they arise. So three Liquid players on the wrong side of the smoke, trying to force their way through, get something sneaky done. But no kills for them just yet. Adren, the last hope. Get one frag and that's going to be that. So, a bit of a nothing round there for Liquid. Did what they could, which wasn't that much. And Follow Esports moves to a 5-round lead and some good money as well.
I mean, they look like they're in this position where they... Follow Esports could get this like really sick situation where, because their money is always high, the potential for them to like reset Liquid, like they're always going to have this like opportunity to do that. And they've been doing damage consistently as well, so...
Ruthless aggression.
If they get to like 10, 11 rounds, they might just be able to win this against Liquid, which would be very surprising. And here we go, fast entries found as they go for the challenge here. Liquid with an aggressive play that was met with even more savage aggression here from Follow Esports, but a few trades and finally it will be cleaned up. So I think that's an acceptable situation for Follow Esports just losing two players. We can see again, just, I mean, I can't emphasize this enough, their money has been so good in this match.
Liquid are trying different things here, but they're just not working out. I mean, just trying to walk through the slope. Maybe they were trying to catch like a site execute. Unfortunately, Follow Esports seem to be one step ahead, making all the right decisions versus Liquid. So, Liquid back on the eco. I'm losing count of how many ecos they've had to go to now.
Yeah, it must have been at least four by now. Maybe this would be the fifth one or something. They can't have had more than three proper buy rounds. Well, we are going to get the aggressive push here. It's going to be working out. Ooh, nice dink. This looks like it could be quite successful this time. Wonderful stuff here. This will be a very big swing on the value.
If they win this, imagine if they win this with nobody dying.
Yeah, that's Slemy's priority. It's just like get some damage in there, get some kills so they can't pick up all the weapons. Because they've picked up four of the weapons, and he needs to take down at least two players here, I would say. I mean, it's going to be bad no matter what, but he needs to try to do damage control right now for his team. Oh, nice headshot found onto Nitro. Pixel was found by Slemy. You could call him the Pixel Hunter. Needs to find more kills though. And there's the AWP of Alish on a very nasty angle, and as well as Fuggly. So this is not going to be an easy task. And Alish will make it happen. And they will take two AWPs away. Maybe even another weapon. No. But still, two AWPs is pretty sick. To be honest. That's a lot of money.
Yeah, they stole a lot of gear there. Which is pretty nice. But of course, the buy continues for Follow Esports. Five AKs, full harassment, loads of mollies, etc. So let's see what the play is. Looks like we're going to have a two-man peek in the mid area, with one being an A rotate. But now the execute is coming out from Follow Esports. So changing up the approach, keeping Liquid surprised and unprepared.
This is so cool because they just did this execute the last time Liquid went around and they crushed them. So, and they're up against orbs. They've isolated away the angles for the orbs with those smokes. If they get the bomb planted immediately, it's going to be really nice. But Fugly, we can see he's able to take down Stewie coming out of the apartments. Oh, actually, the bomb actually went all the way around back to B. So after showing that execute, making it look exactly the same, they've changed where the bomb is going to go. It's now a fake. And we can see Rue moving towards the van here to try to get himself some good angles to clear the site. He will be able to take down Hiko, so the bomb can go down here for the Esports.
Two versus four with two orbs coming their way. This is not going to be easy. Not many places to hide there. Indeed, they will get taken down very, very quickly. 9-3 now coming your way. 8-4, what am I talking about? Liquid surviving in four plays as well, so they could actually bring this back to reasonable score. Follow Esports, their economy's finally been broken here. You see Slimmy down to 3,300.
That was one of those rounds where it's like, it's a really cool idea to actually show the same strategy, but to for the second time for it to be the fake, or even the first time be the fake, and then it's the real one the second time, just like bluffing it basically. But I felt like it worked so well the first time that they didn't really need to necessarily mix it up. Either way, they are going to get picked off here moving into middle. Adren with a nice shot through the smoke, but the spam is going to pay off, and double up setup is still going to be an issue, I think, for Follow Esports. But that said, you know, if we take stock of the situation, right, they've got 8 rounds already on the T side, so they are doing well.
Indeed they are. So CT is going to be the one to smoke off connector, but it will leave a gap for the CT and connector to look over, which is often a problem for T's in the mid area. However, Follow Esports have since abandoned mid. Liquid, I think they're boosting on short again over the bricks, and you can see Elige playing the connector role, playing far with the AWP on CT of A as well. So Follow Esports, a man down, looking to start bringing the nades in. Again, we're seeing a lot more jumping around corners recently, trying to avoid getting shot in the head just like that, Fugly going down towards CT. The AWP not working out for him. 4 versus 4 now. Nice angle through the smoke there to take down the Leash.
That was pretty brutal, that entry from Stewie. I mean, that was a one-shot miss with that AWP initially, and it has meant so much here for Follow Esports. They've got control of the bomb site. It's just two players left, Nitro and Hiko. Big players, but they can't get the job done so far. It's just Hiko left. He's got a lot of work to do. These players are hiding. They're playing this perfectly. It should be impossible, and it will be for Hiko. Slimy with the finishing frag, and 9-4 will be the score, and Liquid have enough money to buy in this round, which is nice. And they can get two AWPs again if they want, actually. But if they lose this round, it's not going to be too pretty. I mean, they'll get $1,900 for the last round, which will leave them in a very sorry state for the buy.
Well, let's see who gets the advantage this time. Again, it was Liquid who got an early advantage in the last one, but could not convert. Follow Esports now with 3 people towards the mid area, just holding passive angles in case there's a fast push from Liquid, but there will be no such push. They have a 2-1-2 set up for the time being. Follow Esports now with 3 towards the B-bomb sites. Get in a position to split with harassment towards A.
Yeah, looks like they will try to get some pressure in and try to feel out the situation. Liquid have shown quite a bit of aggression as well, so I like that that Follow Esports are taking a slower pace to see if they can catch something like that. And now they're making a bit of a move here with the bomb, just dropping it back in T-spawn. And we're going to see the second phase of the round from them after the initial presence in Slope and B Apartments. That said, Liquid are pushing B Apartments as well. They got a close positioning there, so they kind of should have a good idea what's going on.
Well, 3 people moving up short now for the T's, and connectors being smoked off. Is Adrian going to see them fast enough? Realizing what's going on, taking one down. We've got a player in the ladder room now. And Ruse turning around back towards A, so Liquid might not know what's going on here. But they've picked up the bomb. Hiko's taking down Slemmy towards Apps. The rest of the team will get cleaned up by Liquid, and they'll hold on with 4 players to bring it to 9-5. Heading towards 9-6 is the money. It's pretty bad here for Follow Esports.
Yeah, it's looking interesting right now. This is the first time that Follow Esports, I think, actually needs to eco like properly. This is actually the first time. Whereas Liquid, conversely, must have ecoed like 5 times or something. So the match is actually much closer than the score would actually otherwise suggest, I would say. Either way, looks like the execute is the order of the day on towards the A bomb site. Have to see if that's going to pay off for Follow Esports. There is a nice setup here from Fugly and from Elige. They've got a bit of crossfire positions going on. They can flash for each other and cover each other from their weak spots.
Well, let's see if they can do it. Elige gets the first frag. He is close though, at risk of being headshot. There it is, but he's done the damage. 2 men for him, 2 men for Fugly as well. Rube versus four, and he is surely going to go down very quickly in the sandwich area. Being detected, traded by Fuggly in the last round. 9-6 for Esports with a lot of damage done to the CT side of Liquid. They were looking quite lost, Liquid, in the first half of the first half.
Yeah, it's funny quite how much those early rounds really, really meant on the match. And partly it's also because of the fact that Liquid didn't go for the force buy or any sort of force buy. So whenever they did actually go for the eco situation, where they had that choice to force buy to eco, because Follow Esports had like nice anti-ecos and were able to win the round so cleanly overall. I think there's only like one time where Nitro got like a 3k or something, but the rest was really clean. They built so much money. There's like never any pressure on the T economy. And so, I mean, this is something, you know, you see a lot of the top teams doing these days is always trying to keep the pressure on because the pistols are so good. And I largely agree with it much more than I used to, especially since the new hitbox update. See, the pistols are even better, especially the Deagle. Deagle's really legit right now.
Yeah, all the meat shots. All the meat shots all day. So, Liquid now with it all to do on the T side. They need 10 rounds. It could be a long evening for them. Let's see who can take the pistol on this occasion. Full Kevlar on the Follow Esports side. No defuse kits whatsoever. They're just looking to die without any clean swords. Liquid, 3 Kevlars, 2 players looking to execute with nades. And oh, look at this push here. Not allowing Liquid to do what they want. Just a one tap on the second player there for Peter. Looking supercharged now. Rue coming in with a flank through connector. This chase is ridiculous!
No!
The left, right. The right's gonna do it. Oh, Leech goes flying as well. That was really weird. What a bizarre round.
What was that? That's so lame for Leech there. I think it was Leech that got knifed. Because that looks like so horrendous. Like he just like, he's like coming at you. You can see, you know that you're gonna get knifed. That's the worst.
That was just a very, that was just all very weird. Because the push was nice from the two CTs. The one tap from Peter was kind of funky there. Then he gets the knife just swiping away. Then the last player kind of gets shot in the side of the head and just starts sliding across the floor. It's just so weird.
Brilliant.
There we go. We have Liquid with 4 people going towards the B bomb site. But it seems that maybe they're offering a fake. Look, I like how passive the bomb is compared to the 3 players up top. So maybe if they were engaged, then it would look like the bomb was headed towards A and you wouldn't see a full rotation.
Interesting that we're going to see the P250 eco from Team Liquid. No force buy from them. And we are going to have the spray coming from Rue. He's going to do a decent job. Just Fugly left with the cover of Semi and Friends. And Liquid did not get the bomb down in the first round, if I'm not mistaken, right? Pretty sure they did not get it down. Okay, they must have got it down. Okay, so the P250 eco is fine. I thought they actually didn't get it down. I missed that because of the knife shenanigans. It's just like,
you were distracted, Dan. We were very distracted.
I was spinning out. So the AKs come in for Liquid, and if we look at their options, they have 2 smokes, one of which has just been thrown. So you would imagine that it's probably thrown towards mid or early into the round from T spawn if it goes out immediately. And just a leech with the smoke left and a couple of flashes. So they're going to have to go for the raw aim tools here.
So, Liquid with 4 people towards the A site. Ooh, just trying to creep in, but the FAMAS AK is not going to get a chance to even fire a bullet. Now they're going to try and force the issue, pushing through the smoke. There's one frag. Ooh, Hiko's done good work here, opening up the A site. They have a chance to get a plant here, but there's a fast rotation coming in towards CT. Trying to thin out more numbers on the CT side will fail. Peter taking down the Leech there. 2 versus 3 now. Man advantage for Follow Esports. They don't seem to realize where the second player is. They're both below Peter, as you can see there. So the CT's just holding passive angles, trying not to overextend. But again, it seems they're still wondering as to where that second player might be.
Yeah, Semi's pretty key there, because I think he will get an angle onto it safely. Yeah, you can see both Sandwich and Heavens from there, so he's going to spot both players. I'm not sure if he called it to his team, but he will get the first crack and the second one. A bit of spray will do the job on the Fugly. And that was a pretty good shutdown of the round. I mean, if not for Hiko with that just double out of nowhere, it would have been even more crushing for Liquid. And now they've got to go for a save and Follow Esports. They've had like such an amazing map so far for money. Their money, they're in a situation again where they're just going to build a lot of money. Unless Liquid do something phenomenal without any grenades. But that's so hard to imagine.
Ooh, Elige running distraction. And distraction, he has one run. But to what effect? Liquid now looking for a plant, basically. Here we go. That Molotov's going to speed things up here. Slemmy's going to spot. Try and reposition. Try and get away from those one taps there. Eventually, he will be one tapped by Nitro. Trying to put a quick plant now. She's going to land it. And there we go. That is job done for his team. There'll be a $500 profit per person for those who bought PT-50s. And they'll need to make it count here. Because Follow Esports are three rounds away from victory. If they break Liquid again, then who knows what happens.
Yeah, this is pretty nice. But at least Liquid did get the bomb down, as you mentioned. That was the best case, really, and they managed to secure it. And so the AWP will be featured on Adren, and everybody else will finally have grenades utility with the AK. So this is the first time we're going to see a proper buy round for the Liquid T side, and there's only three rounds for Flory Sports to pick up to win the match. So it's a pretty nice situation for them, to say the least. They've been playing good as well, been on their shots. And some good setups, and they have a lot of mid presence at the moment. But interestingly, of course, Liquid are going for a very, very passive play. So if they're deciding to play like hyper passive, they can either catch out an aggression from this setup, or the setup is just going to be wasted from Follow Esports. So Liquid, this is a nice opening.
Okay, so we have the I think we have a CPL smoke coming in from Spawn. And Adren, I don't know if that's CPL or connector. We shall see soon enough. Oh, it seems like it's jungle, actually. Ah, so they're going for a fake. This is interesting. I'm going to have to watch this one on a GoTV because we've got nades coming in towards the A site as well. They've got to hold three people towards A for now. But where is the ultimate goal here, actually? Because Fugly's over towards B. The bomb is moving over there slowly but surely. But is it moving a little bit too slowly? Peter now maybe making a read. Going to take down the Legion short here. That's going to be the call that the A split is being attempted as Nitro goes down as well.
This is pretty huge. The split is no longer a split thanks to Peter. Just to play us through apartments. Same is going to take down one. There's a kill coming back in quickly from Fugly. But only two players left standing for Liquid. Oh, the clutch is starting to work out for them though. Great stuff from Fugly and Hiko saving this one. Oh my goodness. Fugly finding the last one straight through the smoke towards short. Knows his angles, could close his eyes. And 13-7 will be the score. So Liquid with a phenomenal save there. And that was actually a position where Follow Esports could have won the match. Because if we look at their money now, okay, now they actually have to eco. Had they won it, they'd be on 14 rounds, and they would not need an eco. However, Liquid would have done. So pretty huge moment there.
Yeah, that's a massive round for Liquid, especially after those two frags from Peter on short. Basically noticing, realizing the split attempt, but also crushing half of it. Regardless, Liquid bring it back. So, Follow Esports now. You saw when it was Liquid's eco, they mainly focused on the A side. Follow Esports focusing on the mid area. Stewie first to go down. How will his teammates react? Lots of walking going on. They don't want to give their positions away. Want to keep their opponents surprised. So, Adren, where is this smoke going? Is this the jungle one again? We will have to wait and see. I wonder if that's a jump script. I think it probably is. So we have a smoking connector, a smoking CPL. So I imagine it's a CPL smoke then. Well, regardless, we have two players in mid for Liquid, and it seems they're headed towards the A site. Only one Molotov, though, onto Adren.
Yeah, we've got the final push, and there's a frag actually from Peter. So a little bit of damage, but they will otherwise be cleaned up by their Liquid opponents. And there it is, the final engagement for the rounds as Liquid start to bring a close to the lead of Follow Esports, but there's still quite some amount of rounds to go. So five, the deficit for them, and the AWP's going to be on Peter. Last time, Peter did an amazing job hitting two very decisive shots towards Catwalk to basically give Follow Esports a strong chance to win a very key round. So it'd be cool to see if he's on a similar form in this round as well, as Liquid have a bit of an advantage now on some of the weaponry. We see a FAMAS in play for Follow Esports as well. And there it is, a nice defense there from Hiko on Peter. He went for the AWP push. So that's your part of the picture straight away. That's very, very painful right now for Follow Esports. And they lose Zacchaeus in mid.
And I think there's either a connector smoke being thrown onto the A site or a jungle smoke. Regardless, the Follow Esports team is falling apart now. Five round lead for Liquid to catch up on. Doing great work on the economy of the CT side. Now it is just about survival for them. Of course, the AWP will be key.
Yeah, you got to be able to close these leads. Hiko is hunting though, and Sui will take him down. Keeping the AWP alive would be insanely nice, actually. What is the money like for Follow Esports? Let's have a look. So this is going to be the third loss. So that's $2,400 in addition to what they have. So if they save two weapons, they could actually go for a buy, or they could go for a save and have be fully equipped in the following round. But they might not be able to afford orbs if they lose the orbs in the next round. Oh, what a snap there! Gorgeous, gorgeous shot from Stewie TK. Okay, so they can actually go for the force if they really want to.
Let's see what they choose to do. If they go for the force here and they lose though, then
they could
basically catch up.
Yeah, they're not going to do it.
Yeah, more sensible routes. Four players over towards the A site again, with Peter spotting Mir, so all the guns on A for the moment. Bottom left in a passive position, the push pays off though, Hiko's going to fall. Is that going to cause the full rotation from Follow Esports? I'm wondering if they're going to try maybe a faster play towards B. Indeed, they are speeding up now. They're going to bank on only an M4 being towards B at best, so they can try and trade with that, although AWP with a stack on your side may be a bit unlikely. Anyway, here we go. They've taken the site for free. Ooh, Stewie saw an elbow but wasn't fast enough to punish it.
No!
He's going to die to the flames. There goes the AWP.
Yeah, he fought... He felt like it went a little bit too far forward. That he'd be okay. It's very unfortunate for him. But so Liquid clean up. Now that was the only real scary part for this round from Liquid, was that AWP in play. Yeah, that was. I can see what he's going for there though, because he feels like he's definitely going to get a re-peek. So when that Molotov goes in, so he's going to get an opportunity to shoot somebody. And he felt, I'm pretty sure, like, I think that it spread a little bit. I think he was right at the edge, and he had his back against the wall, and it spread a little bit. I think that's what got him. But unfortunate there. Anyway, 13-10, Liquid climbing back. And they've definitely not had the best of times in this match so far, and it would be really annoying for them to have their record tarnished, because right now they have a flawless record on the Faceit League. Ooh, so a bit of a tactical pause coming in. And Follow Esports have to figure out how to use this buy.
It's very rare you see a tactical pause on online games, actually. So this is quite nice. It seems Follow Esports have a new focus now that you've been picked up by a sponsor. They're playing very well today. Very coordinated. Surprisingly so.
Yeah, actually, because for me, it was the first time really watching these players, apart from Peter, of course, in the Faceit League. In this edition of the Faceit League is the first time I really saw them, and they did impress me quite a bit on the cobblestones that I casted with Vendetta. We saw them do quite well. In fact, I think they were playing. Who were they playing? I forget what the matchup was. It was a couple of weeks ago now. Damn, time flies.
Their sponsor reportedly bought a LoL team from Team Dignitas for about $1 million.
Seriously?
As well, yeah. So. They've got a good org behind them, it seems, or at least an org of money. Doesn't mean it's a good org.
Yeah, I was about to say, mate.
I will assume it's a good org.
Yeah, we shall make the assumption at least.
Who knows?
Yeah.
Maybe they have a good incentive. So, it should be unpausing soon. Three mollies on the CT side, just one AWP. AWP onto a drone, of course. The money's not, well, actually, it's all right for Liquid. It can get it back into the game even if they lose this round. Put it that way. Although, with Follow Esports on 13, Liquid will not wish to lose any more rounds. Unpause coming in, so let's see what these CTs have to offer if they can get things back in their control. So, yeah, that's got to be going into CPL. That's jump script. Must be.
Yeah,
I have no opinion on drop scripts though.
Yeah, I assume it would be. Nice push there from Hiko out of the comments. He gets the quick double. That's really nice. That first kill is really fast. And then Peter's just like, he's still in distraction mode, working out what's happening. And he can take it down before he can really figure it out. So the kill will come back in favor of Follow Esports there on the A site. But the push has already happened on B. So Hiko did a really good job there. That completely crushed Follow Esports in this round.
Yeah, that's shut out the round. AWP's lost again, although there are three players over to a site. They will upgrade an M4 and grab the AWP as well. So, Liquid get another round in the bag, and now with Follow Esports saving three rifles, I do wonder if they will buy around this one. I think it's very possible for them to do so.
This would be very frustrating for Follow Esports if they lose this match, because they again they had like the perfect setup to win. Because best of ones do have some variance in them, and I feel like they definitely got the better variance. Not to take anything away from them, because obviously they've been playing very well. But everyone will agree that you know there's a degree of variance when it comes to like which rounds you win and so on. And so they need to be able to close this. And I'm sure they discussed quite a lot of what they should be doing in that tactical pause. And this is the only buy they're going to get before Liquid actually equalize the scoreline. So this is a very important one here for Follow Esports. See if they can pull something together here. We've got Peter on the AWP.
Well, Liquid starting with the passive angles, just making sure there's no aggressive push from Follow Esports. Maybe detecting the desperation on the CT side. And I'll slowly creep and start to take control again. Going to be taking control of both ends of mid. Was that a CT smoke again? I wasn't paying attention to who threw that, but again, it is advantageous from the angle Peter's holding. Though you can see Nitro just waiting patiently for that smoke to go away. Liquid will be looking to take control of Connector at some point, although now their players from top mid have headed towards the A bomb site, so it seems that we may see the split again. Yes, indeed. The entire Liquid's team seem committed.
Yeah, there's two players moving into Connector soon for that triple-pronged attack. So this could be a strong one from Liquid. Let's see if they can get these quick entries. Kiss is in a very important position here. The stairs, classic stairs position. Oh no, it's going to be a very awkward initial engagement. And he will go down in the end. Should be holding it down on the site for now, though, as his teammates try to get that position for a retake going for themselves. It's not really happening here because Liquid are just hitting all the shots and Follow Esports are losing these key one-on-ones. So 2-4 now for Follow Esports, and they don't like their chances. And again, this would be the how many rounds lost in a row now? Let's quickly have a look. And okay, so they're on the max consecutive round loss bonus, meaning that they can force up in the next round. But you would have noticed that they mostly all bought to within like, well, something like, I think most of them have $0 left, apart from one player who had like 2,800. So they're gonna have a really hard time here. They're likely just gonna go for an eco, maybe throw in a few pistols, unless they save both these guns. If they can save both the guns, they can still force it up and it should be decent. And he's gonna take down one. So now it gets a little bit complicated and both players go down. So everybody's gonna have between 3,400 and, as you can see, there's one player with 6K. So awkward situation. Do you buy, you know, Famous Kevlar and maybe have a nade or something, or do you want to be able to definitely have the options available to have better rifles, more grenades, and the double up possibility as well? So smartly, I think Follow Esports are going to go with the safer option, and they're not going to risk it. Gonna eco once again. See some 5-7s. That's mostly it. And now Liquid are the ones, in fact, with double up on the T side. CB2K with the reposition, but see, Adren might catch on to this. He's got the AWP at top mid. Could slowly make their way in to connect. A great kill, though, from Stewie2K. That angle with the smoke down on CPL completely took Nitro off guard, and that's going to be an early advantage on the men, at least, to Follow Esports here, as Adren still waits patiently. But again, if Liquid gets slowed down too much, it might end up being very beneficial for Follow Esports here, because they can work out what's happening, they can start to move people into better engagements, and the longer you take on rounds like this as the tease, the worse it gets. They really need to finish on a bomb site before 30 seconds if possible, so they can have time to really clear properly. And oh no, they're going towards the B bomb site here. We have the full stack almost for Follow Esports. One player in the window can quickly reinforce short, and three in immediate proximity there on the bomb site. Here goes Liquid. Three players jumping to the bomb site now, making those sound cues. This is going to be very awkward. 15 seconds to plant the bomb. The first frag going to Slemmy. We get a couple straight back though for Liquid, as the bomb plant attempt needs to come in. 10 seconds now. The bomb needs to go down straight away. Akis looking for a frag. It's not going to happen. It's all on Peter in this situation. And the bomb barely goes down. But that is going to cost the life of one player and 2 HP left for Elige. Barely winning the round. Liquid receiving immense economic damage. But it won't matter all that much, because they still win the round. They still got a lot of bank. And Follow Esports will finally get themselves a solid buy. So very close to winning that round. Liquid got in a lot of trouble. but Follow Esports will be able to actually go for a mid push, it would seem. Three players focusing heavily on mid. And they have shown this round in the past, and previously Liquid did play very passively, which nullified it. There is the peak. Sunny will spot Nitro. Seeing Nitro in that position pretty much tells them the entire posture of the entire Liquid team, so they're going to back away smartly. Late resmoke for Hiko there. And we do have Liquid still just, you know, waiting it out a little bit. They've got players from underpass moving towards connector, and they're ready to snap into mid.
Control of top and bottom. Will they pursue connector, however? Akis being taken down in CPR. It's going to be a denial of information for Follow Me Sports. 40 seconds though, Liquid have to go for an execution now. Two players in connect are bomb slowly moving towards A, as is the rest of the team. Pico going to be coming out of Palace as well, but there are three Follow Me Sports players. The flank coming in just a bit too late off from short to sort of plays in connector. Rude doing some good work though, slowing down the Liquid push, and Peter might find an angle here.
Ooh, there. Oh, nice snap onto Adren. There is Fugly on their own right. Oh, Peter hits that shot as well. This guy is going ham at the moment, but there's still two players left to kill. The bomb now planted, and there's one directly below him. This could get awkward. In fact, that player is going to actually back away a little bit. I think it may be Nitro. Oh, Hiko. No, it's not. And oh, he still hits the shot. It would be Hiko. Nitro now left, and he will find the frag on to Peter. But it was a great attempt. When Peter's really in the kind of the flow state with the AWP, things get crazy. Seen it before. I think, in fact, that's where he made his name, doing stuff like that against, I believe, LDLC at MG Aspen so long ago.
8 rounds in a row for Liquid. I knew there were things to come on the T side. Very slow and methodical, and it's doing work, but then so is Peter. Although, they can't rely on him to kill everyone. They need to hold elsewhere. He's doing what he can, but Liquid are in the lead now. The bomb's still left in a passive position, and we'll see that nade again into CPL. That lands every time. So we have a push actually on shorts from one of the CTs, but now starting to move back. Maybe hearing the running in B app, is going to head towards B, try and bolster the defenses there. Akis is holding things down in the connector as well, so he can have a look at shorts. Only a lurker in Adren top mid at the moment. Again, Liquid now focused on B.
And the push is about to come in. Slemmy is in a very good position though, but he's kind of, he could easily be isolated, but Ruud's actually pushed forwards. That's good, because now they know where Slemmy is. He'll get the first frag, instantly refrag there. Ruud goes in, he'll get the refrag onto Fugly. Still more work to do though. Adren and Hiko left alive. Great takedown of Ruud from Hiko. That might enable him to plant the bomb, but he's gonna go for the next frag, and he's gonna be able to pick it up, but now he's all alone. Hiko in this 1v2 clutch situation with not much time to play with. The CTs can just keep wasting time and force his hand, and Stewie2k will indeed get the frag. Now, finally, Follow Esports pick up a round. So 14-14, and what is going to happen now? Because they actually lost a lot of players there.
Yeah, the CTs are going to have a worse buy, even though they won the round, because Liquid have just got too much money. So they should have, the T-side should have a lot more nades. Indeed, they will.
Oh, no. No, that's not.
Boost? Boost, boys? I don't know. Why aren't they boosting? Come on. Boost. Oh, lads. Come on, lads. Get that boost on there and retrieve the gun. Well, you could try. But instead, Slemmy will leave with a 5-7.
Oh, dear. That's.
Surely it would work if they boosted there.
Well, I think he was in range from the jump, so maybe it's been blocked by the fence. Maybe that actually blocked. Maybe he's got some collisions on it or something.
I reckon boost guaranteed.
Ooh, oh, no.
Great angle by Fugly.
Rooney needs to try to save the day. He will take down the player, one of the players there, Fugly. But this is still an awkward situation. You've got to go stuck on a 5-7. Everybody's timings have messed up because of that weird the shenanigans and TCD spawn. But they seem to be holding on, though.
Yeah, FAMAS is paying off for the time being. Slimmy will be the one with the 5-7. So numbers have been thinned for Liquid, which means they can't cover as their backs as they might have liked to. But also, taking down Peter means that it's going to be two per site. Nitro just on the other side of the wall from Akis. We'll see who wins that one. Akis almost getting a teammate. Can't save Rue, though. Has to trade for his teammate. Down to 2 versus 2. Down goes the bomb. Leaves getting taken down. Adren to even things up to 1 versus 1 now. But where is Slemmy? I don't think he has any idea. Slemmy's got to be sharp with that 5-7. He'll walk over to the site. Maybe he'll pick up a rifle in his travels. Adren has no idea where he's coming from. Slemmy just banking on Adren backing up into his angle, but he's not going to do so. Slemmy has a kit. We could jump and spot Adren actually from the back of the boxes here if he realizes where he is. Oh, he thinks he's in CT spawn. Adren. Oh, is he going to get it in time?
Oh. Pros don't fake.
And the AWP as well.
In that's the face.
Oh god, that is a mess.
That's beautiful. I gotta say, not only is Slemmy clearly a gentleman and a scholar, James, he's a badass. He's a badass beast.
I mean, not peeking is fine, but then missing the shot, losing the AWP as well, when you're against match point, and now you can't afford an AWP, that's just unlucky. That's very unlucky indeed. Anyway, but it's not over yet. Again, Liquid have the nades, they have the strats, they have the patience. Will it pay off, however? That nade coming in, sailing into CPL once more. And there was a bit of a creep up mid from the CTs, but they chose to retreat that, to cancel that plan. Again, they have all the advantages now. Peter again on point there with the AWP.
He's been so consistent this match, actually. He's really, really been helping massively for them. Now, the push will come into Liquid regardless, the B split, but they're actually being picked up one by one. And it's that trend is not changing at all. It's all onto Nitro. And boom! Follow Esports beat Team Liquid 16-14. Unexpected result. And again, they had a great start on the economy. They really drove it home. I mean, we've got some clutch performances from a lot of the players here on Follow Esports. I think, as you said, they're definitely taking things a little bit more seriously now that they've got a really strong organization at their backs. And we can see the skill. Like, every single player on the team was actually having great games. Slemmy, Stewie, you know, Rue, Peter. Who am I missing? I said Stewie.
Slemmy, Stewie, Peter, Rue, Akis.
Akis, yeah. Akis as well. On the first half specifically, Akis was, I think he got like 10 frags in the first few rounds. He was really fragging quite hard straight away, which was the key moments that gave them such an advantage on the economy. So, yeah, good performance from all the players there. Liquid will be a little bit disappointed because now their record's a bit tarnished. They've got that one loss. They were the only team, I think, that otherwise didn't have any losses. Cloud9 were the only ones above them with just an extra win. So, good stuff.
They will rue the end of that. So, between now and the next game, we have just a few minutes. We are going to do a raffle for one of these, which is a CSGO collectible pin. So, we'll do a raffle. We'll call the command pin. And then we will open it and see what you get. And then we will post it to you. If you want the code straight away as well, we can do that for you. So, we'll see what's inside here after the break. See you in a few minutes.